Hello, it's Anna Kemani. I'm back again for our next session. As we continue looking at this crucial area or topic on how parents or guardians, what you could do to support the young people or students who are under your care to get the best out of their education. And to you young people, for students at whichever stage you are in education, what you could do in order to get the best outcomes, qualifications, and grades. Today, we shall be looking again at the very young children before the age of 3, after the age of 3 when they start school. That is foundation in the lower primary. And also the student or the young children in upper primary or even lower secondary will benefit from today's session. We are looking at numeracy or maths. Again, today I'll be covering and we shall be looking at numeracy or maths, and I'll be exploring and discussing with you parents on giving you some tips on what you could do to support the young children under your care as a parent or guardian to do the best in maths or in numeracy. Last session, we were looking at reading and writing, and again, I said depending on which part of the where they are coming from, because I'm addressing parents, guardians, students from across the whole world. Depending on which part of the country you're coming from, what you call reading and writing, that is what we covered in the last session. So if you haven't watched that video, go back and watch it from my YouTube channel. And we said in the English-speaking countries, here in England, we call it literacy. Again, reminding you, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, Anna G. Kimani, consider subscribing. And after subscribing, remember to hit the bell so that you get notifications each time I upload a new video. Because I am uploading the videos regularly and at least one video per week. So it will be good and beneficial to you once you get the notifications every week and get updates on what I was covering in that video. Again, remember to follow me on my Facebook page, which is Excellence in Education Progress. Excellence in Education Progress at my Facebook page. Again, remember to check my website, which is now live. And my website is annagkimanipublications.com. Again, my website is annagkimanipublications.com. Remember to check it out. So today, I said we are looking at numeracy or maths, and I have to remind you, and again, in all the videos that I've covered before, I've reminded you that the key thing is to make sure you're in touch with the school or the learning institution that your child is attending. Make sure you're in touch with the class teacher for those with you. With the children in primary school, because today we are looking at the young children, the very young children. Although I'll be covering also up to the age of 2 before they start school, I'll mention a little bit on that. But remember to keep in touch with the school. Remember to keep in touch with the class teacher, the teacher that is teaching your child. And for those with children in secondary school, the subject teachers. If your child is in day school, make sure you attend all the parent evenings that your school provides, so that you can go meet with the class teacher, meet with the subject teachers, and get updates on the progress of your child in their education. If your child is in boarding school, remember to attend the parent consultation days so that you can get update on the progress of your child. And remember, we have also said that it is very important for the children, right from very young age, to receive all-round education. We have told you again and again, education cannot be exhausted. So education is all-round, and children need to receive quality and outstanding education all around, in the curriculum, in the extracurriculum, vocational trainings, and all-round trainings starting from home. Depending on the age, the children need to be exposed in all this. Okay, going back to numeracy or maths, we find that most schools, by the time they are breaking for the term, at the end of the term, when you go for, because most schools will have parent evening as the schools are closing before the children go for their holidays, most teachers, and especially in primary and also in secondary school, but mainly in primary, what I've observed myself, most teachers will give you a breakdown of the topic that you'll be covering the following term, as the school opens the following term. So they give handouts on the topic or topics that the children will be looking at the following term. So it is good to, when the children go on holiday, to start looking at that as a parent or guardian. If you could, when the teacher gives a handout at the end of the term, as they explain it to you, I'm sure they'll be giving you some resources here and there, or you could ask if you need extra resources so that you can go through it with your child during the holidays. And then as the child is coming back to school to the new term, as they start these topics, they'll have some background knowledge. Again, remember, the school holidays is time for the children to rest, and everything needs to be done in a very relaxed way. It should be fun. When I was looking at on the session on reading and writing, I reminded you that it should be fun. Even in numeracy or maths, everything should be done out of fun. The young children need to enjoy it. It should be introduced in a fun way so that they enjoy it and they get engaged in what is going on. Okay. Once at the end of the term, you're given the breakdown or these handouts on what you'll be covered the following term, of course, the teachers will give you some resources. Ask for some if you need to, if you need extra. And again, as you go about shopping, maybe bookshop, shopping malls, supermarkets, if you go to the book section, check whether you can see something related to what you have been given by your teacher and buy some. They don't have to be expensive. For example, you find charts with timetables, you can buy that, a big chart with timetables, and come and hang it somewhere on the wall where your child can be checking as they go about doing what they are doing. And I gave you an example of myself when my children were quite young. I used to get a lot of resources from my local post office, because the lady who owned the post office really used to bring some very cheap resources, very good resources in both literacy and numeracy. And I used to check out, and actually my kids would just walk through the book. I didn't have to photocopy. Photocopying could even have been expensive, because the books were cheap enough for them to walk through. Once they finished, I would go and check what else the lady has brought, and I would buy. And I would combine what I've been given by their class teachers and what I'm finding around as I went about my business shopping here and there. So it's good to be involved as a parent or guardian in supporting what your child is going through. So when you now come to look at numeracy, I did check and I found some interesting resource online on how you could introduce your child to numeracy or to maths even before they start school, up to the age of 2 years. And I got what I'm going to read to you from our website, which is www.education.fic.gov.au. That is www.education.fic.gov.au. They have written some very interesting information on how to introduce maths to very young children, even before they start school, up the age of 2. So that by the time they're starting school at the age of 3, they have got some background information in it. I'll read what they have written. A child's first years are a time of rapid learning. Research tells us that babies have an innate capacity to understand numbers. As a child first teacher, you play a key role in developing their numeracy skills from an early age. So here they are saying that yourself as a parent or guardian, you are then your first child teacher, because the most children start school at the age of 3. So before they start school, up to the age of 2, you'll be their first teacher. So you need to look for ways in preparing them early enough. But as I said, it has to be fun so that the children can enjoy it. So on this website, they continue to say, developing numeracy skills early gives children a foundation for their learning and development. It prepares them for daily life, including general problem solving and handling money. Counting is one of the first experiences of maths for young children. Learning to say numbers can begin with a favorite song or rhyme and the repetition of the number names. Children will often say numbers before they visually recognize and identify individual numbers. Here are some activities and tips to engage your child with the counting. Listen to the counting sequence in these groups of songs and rhymes, which are all on YouTube. Five little ducks, TN in the bed, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, once I caught a fish alive, 10 green bottles, 5 little monkeys, 1, 2, buckle my shoe. So, if you have access to the internet, check out from the YouTube on these songs and rhymes that I've already mentioned. Okay, they continue to write and say, children will begin by counting all objects. For example, count with them their fingers and toes, the buttons on their clothes, steps to the house, or their toys. As children move on to counting a set of objects, they begin to link each object with one another. In the beginning, encourage your child to touch each object as they say the matching numbers. So that is how to introduce maths to children up to the age of 2, even before they start school at the age of 3. So check out that, and I hope it will be beneficial to benefit you as a parent or guardian in starting your child off with numeracy or with maths. Okay, now coming back to children when they start school, like from a very young age, I told you it's very important to keep in touch with your child class teacher, like from 3 years, nursery, reception, depending on the curriculum that is being followed in your country. And as the children grow up or as they develop, once they are given homework at school, especially at foundation, lower primary, upper primary, lower secondary, we are looking at the young children. When they are given homework at school, as a parent or guardian, check and make sure that they complete the homework. Check and make sure they complete the homework. If there's somewhere you have to sign to confirm that they have done the homework, if they have got diaries that they bring home, sign it. So that because it will be taken back to the teacher or their class teacher. If you can be able to go through the homework with your child, that's better. Go through it, see whether they have done it in the correct way. And if you can't, do not worry about it. Just encourage them to complete it anyway. Make sure they don't leave any gaps. Encourage them to complete all the work, because their teacher gave that work knowing that they have been taught at school. So encourage them to complete it. Encourage them not to leave any gaps. And then once they take it back to school, as the teacher is marking through their work or going through their work, the teacher will pick out whatever they missed and correct it with your child at school. But for you as parent or guardian is to ensure that the homework is completed. Again, if you cannot be able to help out as a parent or guardian and there are other adults or other grown-up children in the home, you can encourage them to check out with their child and see whether they have done it right. You can encourage them to support them as well. All right. The next thing is, as a parent or guardian, I want to bring to your attention that the timetables are introduced quite early to the children at school. And make sure that you keep in touch with the class teacher, ask for how to support your child with timetables at home to help them practice. And as I told you that you can buy a chart, you can get a chart, a big chart, and put it on the wall, and your child will be saying the timetables as they go about doing their business at home, whatever they are doing, it will become part of fun. And if you need extra resources, I'm sure the teacher you have given these resources, you can ask the teacher to help you. Keep in touch with the class teacher or the subject teacher. That's the key thing. Okay. So children work at different potentials. Some will get it quick than others. But as long as the child is working to their fullest potential, that is what matters most. Children should know all their timetables from 1 to 12 by the age of 8 or by the age of 9 years. So by the age of 8 years, some children will have known all their timetables from 1 to 12, and others maybe at the age of 9 years. But as parent or guardian, and the teachers will be following up, their class teachers will be following up. So as parents and guardians, make sure that you are aware that your child is comfortable with their timetables. By the time they are coming to the age of 9, they know their timetables from 1 to 12 comfortably. Because math develops from timetables. Math develops in a child, numeracy developed in a child by knowing all their timetables up to 12 comfortably. And then the rest of the math, the rest of the complex math start developing from there. We find that once a child understands the timetables, their timetables up to 12, they understand the rest of the complex topics like fractions, decimals, long divisions, and these hence start building their math knowledge. So that's why it's important for them to know their timetables when they are quite young, early enough, the age of 8, the age of 9 years, they should know all their 12 time, their timetables up to 12, and then from there they'll start developing and getting better with in complex maths, whether it is fraction, decimals, wrong divisions, etc. And as they grow up, as they move from lower primary, upper primary, lower secondary, and as they go even to higher secondary, and they continue taking their GCSEs or whatever you call it in your country, at the end of high school, as they go to A levels, if they decide to continue with the maths in A levels, that will be okay when they get the right foundation from very young age. Okay. Something else I wanted to bring to your attention as a parent or guardian. Make sure you attend the school maths workshop. Most schools, from my observation, have got the math workshops where the class teacher, right from very young age, I remember attending my children math workshop from nursery, where the class teacher, all the way from nursery going up to the end of especially the lower primary school, where the class teachers would invite the parents and guardians to come to school and spend 2 hours where the parents or the guardian work with their child and the teacher come around and guide the children, show the students what to do, and the parents are there. So once you attend this workshop, you get to know how to support your child when you're at home with them. So it's important to attend the workshop, the math workshops. And if you're listening to me and this facility of math workshop or any other subject workshop, but here I'm concentrating on maths, are not available in the school or the learning institution where your child is attending, you need to ask the class teacher whether it can be started or it can be introduced. And if you are listening to me and you happen to be a class teacher or a head teacher or in leadership, or in another part of the world where these facilities are not available, please consider starting it. Be the pioneer, start it so that the parents or guardians are invited to come to school. Even if it's for 2 hours, they work with their children alongside their class teacher and other support staff that they bring along, so that the parents also get the knowledge on how to support their children while at home. It's very important. It gives the children a very good foundation. Here we are looking at how the young people across the whole world can get quality education, good and quality, outstanding education across the whole world, depending on whether they are attending schools from city schools, suburb schools, schools from very remote parts of the country or parts of the world, the students or the young people need to get the best education, the best quality and outstanding education. That's what I'm emphasizing on. So we need to look at what could be done. For those of you who have got these facilities already, that's okay. And for those of you who still haven't got it, I'm sure there's someone listening to me. Go back to those schools, see whether it's happening. And if you're coming from very remote areas and God has helped you, and you need to go back and check, go back to your roots and check whether these facilities are available. Because for me, when I was growing up, we didn't have these facilities where our parents could be invited to come to school and work alongside us as students in our workshops. We didn't have that. But things change, education change a lot with time. So you need to go back and check whether these facilities are there. See what you could do to support the young people and the parents or their guardians, with their parents and their guardians. Okay. All right. Okay, coming here. As a parent or guardian, remember to be involved in your child learning experience. It's very important. Remember to give your child verbal and practical encouragement. Verbal, encourage them. Praise them. Praise is a very powerful tool to help their children to do well in education. Praise them when they do it. Praise them verbally. Tell them you have done well. And also, okay, be encouraged with practical encouragement. Get involved in what they are doing. Even if you're not literate enough to be involved in helping them in literacy, reading and writing, or in maths, encourage them to do it anyway. The class teacher will go and pick it up when they what they missed out. In numeracy, literacy, and in other subjects, supplement resources from school with other appropriate ones that you can get. That is very important. If you have got access to online, check out. Again, when it's come to schools, the class teacher will guide parents on the website, the online facilities to visit and practice with their children, or their children can practice at home if they have got access to technology or to internet. And again, depending on where the students are coming from, because I'm addressing the whole world, I'm addressing globally, I'm talking to parents or guardians and students from across the whole world. In another video, I said that every child from very young age need to be exposed to information technology. It's very important because it is embedded in all subjects. Technology is everywhere. So it is the responsibility of the local government or the national government to make sure that children in their countries, the students back in their countries, from whichever part they're coming from, even in the countryside schools, the very remote schools, get access to information technology. There is internet, so that they benefit like any other child coming from all parts of the world. When effort is put in, it can be achieved. I have said again and again that education is teamwork. Children need to be exposed to all subjects in the curriculum, the timetabled subject, extracurriculum, vocational trainings, and all-out training. It's important. Okay, I'm going to read from my book as well, what I've written in my book. I've introduced this book again and again. It's me who has written this book. It's Parents and Guardians, How You Can Support Your Children Through Education. To your students, learn how to push those grades up, maximizing your child's educational potential. Anna Kimani, it's me who has written it. And I'll tell you what I've written when it's come to math or numeracy. And I've written, in math, practice, patience, and perseverance are the key things to enhance understanding the questions. And again, I've written and said, as a parent or guardians, if you want your child to stand out, remember, the key thing is a bit of extra support and consistency. So, that is from my book. If you haven't ordered this book, consider ordering it. It has got a lot of information. I can't read everything. I know I've given a number of quotations from what I've written, but I can't read everything. When you place the order for the book, you'll be able to read everything that I've written, and you benefit a lot. Below this video, I am going to put the links or guidelines on how you could order the book or how you can access the book. Okay. So, I'll repeat here. Remember, the key thing is keeping in touch with the school as a parent or guardian with the children from a very young age when they start school. As they develop and continue with their education, remember to keep in touch with the class teacher, the teacher who is teaching them in that academic year. and also their subject teachers for those who are in secondary school and above. Again, remember to attend the parent evenings for those of you who are in with children in day school. And for those of you with children in boarding schools, remember the parent consultation days. And in, when it's come to maths, I've said about attending your child workshop, maths workshop. Remember to attend and work alongside your child with a teacher at school. You get a lot of knowledge. And I've said, if you're listening to me and these facilities are not available in the school your child is attending, or in the learning institution that your child is attending, then speak it out, be the pioneer, and see how it can be started. And for those of you who have been privileged, and maybe you have now in a position to help the parents back to your roots, to get started, to get better, the schools back from where you're coming from your roots, then go back and see what you could do so that the children there can get the best quality, the best and quality and outstanding education. Okay, it's Anna Kimani reminding you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Anna G. Kimani. Once you subscribe, remember to hit the bell so that you can get notification each time I upload a video, because I am uploading them regularly, looking at this crucial topic on parents or guardians and the student themselves. You benefit a lot. Remember to follow me on my Facebook page, which is Excellence in Education Progress. Again, remember to check out my website, which is annagkimanipublications.com. Remember to give me some like, they encourage me. Remember to comment, what else could I cover on this crucial topic? Which other areas are you interested in? Because like the last two sessions, this one and the last one, which I covered on reading and writing and numeracy for the very young children, some parents wrote to me and asked me to cover, do some videos on how to support the very young children. And I've managed to cover up to the age of two, even before they start school, in both reading and writing and numeracy. And also at the start school from the age of three and going up, what a best practice as a parent or guardian you could apply to support your child. So if you comment there and let me know any other areas you could be interested in, I'll share my expertise and my experience and do further research and share it with you on this platform, on my YouTube channel, through my videos. All right. Thank you for your time. I really appreciate it. I'm looking forward to meeting you in the next session. Goodbye.